So there's this picture, this photo of my two younger siblings, Iber and Kiana. And it's interesting because at the time there was four of us, but my mom decided to have the two of them take a professional photo and left the two older ones out. So my brother, Iver, is 2 years old, and my sister is not quite one, but she's sort of at the stage where she can sit up on her own. And so they both look incredibly miserable in the photo. Like, my sister's pulling on my brother's hair, and my brother's, like, coordinated vests and bottoms is off to the side. And they have tears rolling out of their eyes, and snot coming down, and they looked so annoyed by each other and fully tormented by the experience. And the thing about Iber and Kiana is that they're both Geminis. Kiana's born on June 5th, and Iber's born on June 6th, so that meant that they always had their birthdays together. And so since Iber is the oldest one, he would insist on some gender-specific theme, like He-Man or Thundercats, whereas my sister just only cared about the cakes and whether or not there would be fried chicken or chicken nuggets or something fried in chicken at the party. And what's really great about them is that they're so quintessentially Geminis. They have the gift of gab. They are incredibly social, and that dual nature of theirs is, you know, even more stark when you notice when they're healthy and when they're sick. So Ibert and Kiana spent most of their childhoods going in and out of hospitals. Ibert, when he would get sick, his neck would sort of swell up almost to like three times its original size. And it was hard to swallow, it was hard to eat. He couldn't move his neck at all and would stay home from school a lot and ask me to bring him home candy. And so the doctors tested to make sure that it wasn't cancer, but there was a lot of visits at the children's hospital bringing him pizza. And so what we eventually found out is that it wasn't cancer, but it was this rare blood disease, lymphedema, where he had a series of blockages in his lymphatic system. So what we would do is make sure that Iber had the warmest turtlenecks and scarves and made sure that he would never sleep under the fan during the summers. And as for Kiana, with her developmental disabilities, and she would never learn at grade level, and she had a speech impediment that turned words oceanic, as well as epilepsy, these seizures that where you can see the electricity in her body just take over. And so Kiana needed far more attention than Ibert did. And so as growing up, everybody wanted to know what was wrong with Ibert, what was wrong with Kiana. And so Ibert had scars on his neck, and even family and friends alike wanted to know, like, why were they there? Why was it that Kiana's elevator never went to the top floor? And so we would ask this, because we didn't know the answer, and so we would go to our mom and ask, so how did Kiana become the way that she is, and how did Ibert get so sick like that? And my mom would say, well, it was a really hot time in Guyana. It was over 100 degrees. And Ibert was only 2 years old, and Kiana was a baby. And I knew that I shouldn't have taken them to South America, but your father's family wanted to see the two youngest kids. And at the time, she stayed in a shack in the countryside where there was like no running water, no hot water, no toilet, nothing. And I just remember my mom saying there was no toilet paper and we had to use newsprint. And then there's another element in the story where enters this Obeah woman, which is basically like a witch. And so she winds up delivering these sweet treats to the American woman with her two American children. And my mom eats the sweet treats, and she gives one to Iber, and she gives one to Kayana. And then afterwards, they become really, really sick. And my mom had to take my sister to the hospital, and she said the hospital was like an hour away, because at that time, my sister started to have these seizures that wouldn't stop. And so later, my mom found out that this woman, this Obeya woman, put a curse on her two kids because she was revenging the broken heart of her daughter, who was very upset that our father went to America and didn't take her, and then fell in love with our mother. So whenever we were at the playground or at family functions and people wanted to know, like, what was up with Ibert and Kayana, we would just simply say, well, a bad witch put a curse on them. And so for a while, this worked, like, through elementary school, but didn't really stick for too long. But in some ways, knowing this kind of, like, fairy tale existence of, like, my sister and brother's ailments gave us this, almost this sense of, like, bad things happen out there and nothing happens, like, in the family or really close. And so what we would do, like, while me and my brother Ibert were walking to and from school, is that we would make these sort of statements, these wishes, or just kind of state the obvious, because we were either frustrated with Kayana. And so most of our statements started like, if Kayana was normal, she would be able to get herself off of the school bus. If Kayana was just like us, then she would be able to do chores and we wouldn't have to take care of everything. And if it wasn't for that witch, Kayana would have been able to, like, play with us in the yard without running off in the street. So we always blame that witch. And so I later found out earlier this year, I was talking on the phone with my mom, and so I don't really know how we happened to get to this, but I'm on the phone and I'm talking with her, and I learned that if it wasn't for the concrete floors in the apartment where we lived on 1625 Fulton Street in Brooklyn, and if it wasn't for my mom being attentive to the dishes, thinking that Kayana and Ibert were sound asleep in the bedroom, and if it wasn't for Ibert, who was curious in that very Gemini way, wanting to hold his sister and then lifting her out of the bassinet, and if it wasn't for him not knowing any better. And so my mom says at the end of that conversation, I've been trying to figure out a time when I should tell him, but never now seems like a good time. Thank you.